It's Londa Wayne by the Bay.
I'm Rhonda Arrington Bay, as your wife. I'm at Whole Foods in Annapolis, Maryland. And I'm about to read the Holy Quran as a natural, civilized spirit, natural life, and under the divine laws of freedom. I'm about to read the Holy Quran, chapter 3. Starting with a reread, starting with section 11 and 12. I might read it some more. Last week, as I was studying, I was reading the Holy Quran, and I was able to connect the Constitution of 1787, freedom of religion. I think that's Amendment 1, with some of the verses of the Holy Quran. And it really made me feel well as a natural divine being implementing natural law. A civilized natural divine being implementing natural law. And that goes, when I say that, my thoughts are, as Moorish Americans, we know that we civilize all nations. And demonstrating who our ancient ancestors are through our natural clean thoughts, divine words, and divine behavior is important because it separates you from the beast in the field. And that's also the same as demonstrating a religion, which is to bind you back, which is part of your thoughts, words, and deeds, too. So it's important. Okay, so I'm going to start off by rereading. I already read this, the whole Quran, the Holy Quran, once. Imani Gray Hyphenate also reread the whole, read the Holy Quran once. Now we are rereading it again and writing more notes. So this is the Holy Quran, chapter 3, section 11. It says, Muslims exhorted to remain united, which is the holy day for all Muslims, is Friday. O you who believe, keep your duty to Allah as it ought to be kept, and die not unless you are Muslim, and hold fast by the covenant of Allah altogether, and be not disunited, and remember Allah's favor to you when you are in your enemies. Then He united your hearts, you know, by His favor you become brethren, and you were on the brink of a pit of fire. Then He saved you from it. Thus Allah makes clear to you His messages, that you may be guided. And from among you, there should be a party, clean bodies, to good, and join the right, and forbid the wrong. And these are they who are successful. And be not like those who become divided and disagree after clear arguments that come to them. For them is a grievous chastisement. For the day when some faces turn white and some faces turn black, then as to those whose faces are black, did you disbelieve after your belief? So taste the chastisement because you disbelieve. And as to those whose faces are white, they shall be in Allah's mercy. Therein they shall be. These are the messages of Allah, which we recite to thee with truth. And Allah desires no injustice to his creatures. And to Allah belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. And to Allah are all affairs returned. Section 12, Relations of Jews and Muslims. You are the destination raised up for men. You enjoin good and forbid evil, and you believe in Allah. And if the people of the book had believed, it would have been better for them. Some of them are believers, but most of them are transgressors. They will not harm you save a slight hurt. And if they fight you, they will turn their backs to you. Then they will not be helped. The basement will be their lot with whatever they are found. Except under a covenant with Allah and a covenant with men. And they shall incur the wrath of Allah, and humiliation will be made to cling to them. This is because they disbelieve in the messages of Allah and kill the prophets unjustly. This is because they disobeyed and exceeded the limits. They are not all alike. Of the people of the book, there is an upright party who recite Allah's messages in the night time, and they adore him. They believe in Allah and the last day, and they enjoy good and forget evil, and be one with another in good deeds. And those are among the righteous. And whatever good they do, they will not be denied it. And Allah knows those who keep their duty. Those who disbelieve, neither their wrath nor their children will avail them aught against Allah. And these are the companions of the fire. Therein they abide. The lightness of that which they spend in the life of this world is as the lightness of wind, and which is intense cold. It smites the harvest of the people who are unjust to themselves and destroys it. And Allah wronged them not but they wronged themselves. O you who believe, take not for intimate friends others than your own people. They spare no pains to cause you loss. They love that which distresses you. Vehement hatred has already appeared from out of their mouths, and that which their hearts conceal is greater still. Indeed, we have made the messages clear to you, if you understand. Lo, you are they who will love them, while they love you not, and you believe in the book, in the whole of it. And when they meet you, they say, we believe. And when they are alone, they bite their fingertips and race against you. Say, die in your rage. Surely Allah is knower of what is in their hearts or what is in deep. If good befells you, it grieves them. And if an evil afflicts you, they rejoice at it. And if you are patient and keep your duty, their struggle will not injure you in any way. Surely Allah encompasses what they do. Section 13, the battle of Uhud. Or Uhud, I think it's Uhud, but I'll make sure. And when thou didst go forth early in the morning from Bethlehem to assign to the believers their position for the battle, and Allah is hearing and knowing. When two parties from among you thought of showing cowardice, and Allah was the guardian of them both, and in Allah should the believers trust, and Allah certainly helped you at Badr when you were weak. So keep your duty to Allah that you may give thanks. When thou didst say to the believers, does it not suffice you that you that your Lord should help you with 3,000 angels sent down? Yea, if you are steadfast and keep your duty, and they come upon you in a headlong manner, your Lord will assist you with 5,000 of havoc-making angels. Islam. And Allah made it only as good news for you, and that your hearts might be at ease thereby. And help comes only from Allah, the Mighty, the Wise, that He may cut off a part of those who disbelieve or abase them, so that they should return and fail you. That thou hast no concern in the matter, whether He turns to them mercifully or chastises them. Surely they are wrongdoers. And to Allah belongs whatever is in the heaven and whatever is in the earth. He forgives whom He pleases and chastises whom He pleases. And Allah is forgiving and merciful. Islam. So that is chapter 3, verse 11, no, 10, no, 11, 12, and 13. Islam.